lot of machine learning algorithms are classified as black boxes. In this video, I aim to solve one of the black boxes by helping you visualize multiple decision trees that are grown inside a random forest. So I hope you enjoy it. Let's start by importing the necessary modules. I've created a function called as save_decision_trees_as_png, which takes in the decision tree classifier, takes in the iteration number, the feature name, and the target name. The first thing that we do is we create a variable called as file_name, which would later be used to reference the different decision trees that we later export as PNG files. In the next step, we call the export_graphviz function, which generates a graph viz representation of the decision tree, which is then returned to an out file. In our case, we are not exporting this as an out file. We are saving all the results into a variable called as .data. Whatever graph viz representation is saved in the variable .data, we use a function graph_from_.data from the py.plus library to import that in form of a graph. From the graph variable, we use the function called as .write_png to write that graph representation as a png file. Let's import this function. Now that our function is ready, which would help us visualize the multiple decision trees inside a random forest, let's first start by importing the iris dataset. These are my feature names and these are my target classes. The next thing that I do is I create an instance of the random forest classifier with just 5 estimators or 5 decision trees and save it into a variable called as model. Once this is done, I fit my data, that is my training data containing your features and target, into the model and I run the cell. Internally, there would be multiple decision trees created. Since we have defined the total number of decision trees that we require in this random forest to be 5, we would see a total of 5 decision trees created. Let's look at all the decision trees that are created. So this is my first decision tree. This is my second decision tree, third, fourth, and fifth. If I have to access my first decision tree, I make use of indexing and I get the first decision tree that I have. If I want to find out the total number of decision trees that are there in my random forest, I call the length function on model.estimators_ and it rightly gives me a value of 5. The next thing that I do is I call the function that I had created previously and I iterate over every decision tree that was created in my random forest. Let's see what I observe. So internally there are 5 PNG files generated or 5 image files generated corresponding to individual decision trees. The next thing that I do is I collect all the PNG files and save it into a variable called as images, which contains all the images represented into a PIL image format. And I use the IPython's display and image function to display the various PNG images that I have loaded in form of a PIL image format. So let's see how it looks. So this is my first decision tree inside a random forest. This is my second decision tree. This is my third decision tree. This is my fourth decision tree, which is very long. And this is my fifth decision tree. So this was my take on how you can visualize multiple decision trees that constitute a random forest. One of the limitations of this approach is if you have great number of decision trees that you're growing, then visualizing all of them individually would be difficult. But yet, this is still a very powerful tool when you consider that if you have very little decision trees in your random forest, then visualizing individual decision trees and then presenting this to the business would make a lot of sense. So I hope you all enjoyed the video. If you do have any questions with what we covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then the easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also it's a huge help to share these videos with anyone whom you think would find them useful. Please consider clicking the subscribe button to be notified for future videos. And thank you so much for watching the video.